Today, when companies are getting listed on the share markets, they know exactly the kind of scale that they are hoping to achieve in the next. Hello and Namaste, Paycheck Pro. I'm Manish Ahuja and this is Paycheck to Profit, India's first YouTube channel dedicated to your financial freedom. On this channel, I create new videos on 4th, 14th and 24th of every month. These videos are created both in Hindi and English language. The idea is that I come from India and most of my viewers, at least on this channel at the moment, are from the Indian subcontinent. So Hindi and English allows me to cater to most of the audience. So just in case, अगर आपको यही वीडियो हिंदी में देखना है तो आप इसे हिंदी में भी देख सकते हैं. एंड इफ़ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी एंड यू हैड नो आइडिया व्हाट डिड आई जस्ट टॉक इन द लास्ट 10 सेकंड्स, डोंट वरी, यू कैन कंटिन्यू वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो इन इंग्लिश. इन टुडेज़ वीडियो आई एम गोना बी टॉकिंग टू यू अबाउट IPO. These three alphabets that you probably have seen over and over again if you watch business news channels or if you just read news on an average, because today IPOs are the boom in the Indian stock markets, Indian equity markets, and it is very important for you to know what IPOs are, even if you're not necessarily interested in investing. However, if you're not interested in investing, you should subscribe to this channel and watch all our past videos and continue watching our future videos, because investing is very important. It will take you closer to your financial freedom. So basically, what is IPO? IPO, the full form is initial public offering, as you can see it in the middle of the screen right now on a sticker. So what exactly is IPO, or initial public offering? So let me explain this to you in as simple manner as possible. Let's imagine we are in 1950s or 1960s. Companies in India are still trying to get past the license raj and they are still trying to get big. And to grow big or to expand the scale and size of the company, the promoters have to take a part of the company and list it on the stock markets or on the equity markets. And who invest in these parts of the companies? Common investors like you and I. So what exactly used to happen is, to grow the scale of the company, loans were very expensive and it was not easy to get loans. And at the same time, capital from other countries or the foreign capital was not easily accessible to Indian investors or Indian companies or Indian promoters. So as a result of which, Indian promoters and founders of companies did not have an option but to raise capital directly from equity markets or shareholders like you and I. Today, the situation has got a little more complicated, not necessarily complicated, it has become more corporate, but the principle still remains the same. Today, let's imagine a company is formed in the year 2000. Till date, it has had a run of 19 years. In these 19 years, probably a startup which started in a small garage today has grown to a company of, let's say, 100, 200, 500 crores, or maybe even 1000 crores. And now these companies have not grown from a garage to 100 or 1000 crores just by themselves. Today what happens, as you must be reading in newspapers or in news websites everywhere, a promoter has multiple options to raise capital, maybe let's say from venture capitalists, seed fund, angel fund, private investors, HNI investors, etc, etc, etc. So as a result of which, all these investors invest in smaller size companies or startups with the scope or with the hope that when these companies grow big enough, they will dilute their investment when the company goes for an IPO. For that matter of fact, venture capitalist funds invest in every company with an exit in mind. So let's say if I'm a venture capitalist, I will invest in company A, let's say at 10 rupees per share, and I will wait for, let's say, 4 or 5 years in my horizon, knowing that at the end of 5 years, I will exit my stake in this company at, let's say, 20 or 30 or maybe even 100 rupees per share when the company goes for an IPO. Why do these venture capitalists invest in such companies? Because one, the scope of profit is much larger, but at the same time, the scope of risk is equally large, because not every startup that actually starts off ends up capturing the market share and grows to a scale where they can see an IPO. So for the risk that these venture capitalists takes in the startup, their risk to return ratio can be really high. So basically, as an investor, what you're supposed to know is, when you're investing in an IPO, you are investing in a company which is just starting to raise capital from the markets. Today, when companies are getting listed on the share markets, they know exactly the kind of scale that they are hoping to achieve in the next 5, 10, 15, 20, maybe even 50 years. Today, India is one of the fastest growing economies of the world. Look at any industry, and every industry is still on its growth phase. So every time an IPO comes out, and if you're trying to invest in the company, try to figure out the business of the company. Who are the promoters of the company? What kind of background do they come from? Who are the investors or the venture capitalists who have invested in these companies, and how much of their stake are they diluting? All of these informations, which are not necessarily financial balance sheet related information, these are clues which you will get at the time of IPO by reading their red herring prospectus or just reading news about the company, which will help you decide if you should invest in that company or not. So as you may have now understood, IPO are just three alphabets, but when put together, initial public offering is a very important tool that every investor must at least have information of, so that when you invest in companies, you may get maximum advantage of being invested in good companies, and you can make a good handsome return on your investment in times to come. For example, if you would have invested in companies like ITC or Infosys or Reliance 20, 30 years ago, even if you would have just invested 10,000 rupees in these quality companies, today your investment would have grown to hundreds and thousands of crores. That is why it is important for you to know about IPOs. Does this mean that you should invest in any and every IPO? Please do not even think about it. The idea is, you should know the concept of IPOs, you should do your research, you should make sure which company you are investing in. But IPO is definitely something that will probably help you get a faster or a much sturdy return over a period of time, should you invest in a good company. So I hope you've understood something about finances and IPOs today. As I keep telling you, financial investment is a very technical topic, but it is not very difficult to understand. Should you invest some time in this, or should you invest some time and effort to understand what this industry and what this concept is all about? I hope you found today's video to be really helpful. If you like the video, please do not forget to like the video. Please share it on all the social media channels that you are active on, so that more and more people can get to know about IPOs, about paycheck to profit, about financial literacy and financial freedom per se. If you have any questions, please do not forget to just add them down to the comment section below, and I will do my best to answer them for you. That's about it from me for today. Now I'll see you in the next video. Until then, keep smiling, take care of your loved ones, and stay happy. Ka-ching!